this conversation's been great, and we're almost, you know, at the end of our time. There's one last, you know, kind of area I wanted to unpack. So in the book, there's a chapter called Lost and Found. And it's basically the story of my great aunt, Aunt Donna, who's like my second mother. And the interesting thing is that when I was younger, you know, I'm the middle child of three boys. So I felt like, you know, I didn't have my place. You know, I was always, you know, saying, hey, where do I fit? Because all the attention I felt went to my older brother, younger brother. So Aunt Donna, when I was like 5 years old, really took a liking to me. And she would, you know, make sure that I was heard. She would, you know, I would spend time with her. And so over the years, we developed this really close bond. Now, Aunt Donna has one child, one daughter. And so, you know, that daughter and her, you know, when she was growing up, they were had a pretty good relationship. But as her daughter came into womanhood, you know, her and Aunt Donna were inseparable. OK, like, I mean, just the closest ever. When she was young, her daughter came out and said, hey, you know, I'm lesbian. And Aunt Donna, she talked about this in the book. At first, she had some challenges dealing with that. And then ultimately she said, you know what? You're my daughter. I love you. Accepted her. They became this close.
Yeah.
Long story short, for a variety of circumstances, her daughter ends up seeing someone. That person seemingly puts a wedge between her and Aunt Donna. And my cousin, her daughter, ends up leaving the house, moves somewhere, potentially on the East Coast. And for 30 years, they have not spoken. Yes, for 30 years. Her only child. They never had an argument. They never had a disagreement. She left. And that was the last that she has heard of her. And the irony of me being her surrogate son, I'm like the only child that she has. And so the reason why I bring that up, you know, is so many parents and people even listening to this, the mother-daughter relationship, you know, as beautiful as it is, can also be difficult. You know, and what you all are modeling right now, not just in this conversation, but how you live, how you present, is really showing that not only does it take a woman, but, you know, as mother and daughter, there can be unity, there can be friendship, there can be love, there can be boundaries, there can be respect. And it's a beautiful thing to see how, you know, you all model all of those things in a seamless way. In an organic way and in a truthful way. There's a lot of brokenness out there, a lot of brokenness in family relationships. Yeah. How do you hold it together? How do you keep the bond strong? Some people are watching this right now and they have fractured relationships with their family. There could be their parents. It could be other siblings. What's the key? And I'd love for both of you just to give your insights on this before we close. What's the key to keep, you know, our family relationships strong?
I know the one thing that I always do when I feel like we might not have been connecting as much as usual, I always make sure that we check in and we do our little talks and we just catch up on everything, because that's when I feel like we're the closest. So I feel like you keep your kind of traditions alive, keep doing the things that like you've always been doing that, you know, make your relationship so strong. Because we always talk and we always be talking about everything and showing each other videos and just, you know, we have our little hangouts. So I feel like keeping tradition going is like essential to maintain a relationship.
Wow. Love that.
You know, for me, I think honesty is the key.
Yes.
And the honesty has to start within.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Tell myself the truth,
mm-hmm.
how I feel about something, so that my daughter, you know, can also be truthful to me.
Yeah.
But I think when we are honest with each other, then we have no choice but to communicate. Right. Mm-hmm. And things feel better because now we're not holding anything.
Yeah.
There's nothing in the way There's nothing bridging, you know, there's no need for a bridge.
Sure.
We're on the same island together. But, you know, it just breaks my heart to hear that story.
I know. I know.
You know, a lot of times when nothing is said, a whole lot is said. And so there's something where the truth was not told.
Yeah.
And if we tell the truth, then the truth tells the story.
There you go.
And then we can be back here.
Yeah. So, yeah. And I love that, what you're saying, because, you know, my intent and the intent of my mother and my great aunts in participating in bringing to the world It Takes a Woman is to tell the truth.
Yeah.
Because so often in our culture, in our community, we don't talk. We don't tell the truth. We a lot of times hide it. You know, people have listened to this audiobook and have said, oh, my goodness, you guys are too honest. No, don't say all that. Yeah. And it's like, no, this is exactly what we have to say, because truth transforms. And when we tell our stories, we have no idea how those stories can help heal and uplift whoever may be in the vicinity of hearing them. So I just want to say thank you, Tab. It's you, my sister. It's always good seeing you. Choyce, you, my new sister. It's always good seeing you too. Thank you all for first of all, sharing your hearts with the world. You know, we're at a time now where we need positivity. We need hope. We need truth.